So the headlines going around on the internet say that flies can feel fear. Excellent. Hello to all you fly honeys. Julian here at YouTube Space LA for DNews. Like I said, if the internet is to be believed, then we are giving poor little fruit flies spaz attacks just from waving our hands at them. The news comes from a study from the California Institute of Technology, but there's more gray area than some black and white headlines would lead you to believe. One of the study's authors, Dr. David J. Anderson, says we can only know if a creature is feeling emotions by asking them directly. Of course, if you ask a fly anything, all they'll say is, so, the scientists had to set up some parameters that separated emotions from a simple reflex. The criteria they settled on was that any emotion has certain characteristics. These emotion primitives were scalability, persistence, generalizability, and valence, which in the context of psychology means how attractive or averse something is. The scientists put the flies in a chamber and occasionally passed a shadow overhead to simulate a bird or a Batman coming for them. When the shadow came, the flies would run, hop, or freeze in place. When the shadows swooped by more frequently, they would run and hop faster, which showed scalability. They repeated this with food in the flies' chamber, and they got the same result. This fulfills two other criteria of being generalizable to different contexts and having negative valence that overcomes the attractiveness of that sweet, mushy brown banana. The flies would also take longer to come back to the food the more they were antagonized, and that demonstrates persistence. Rather than just hopping away and coming back when the danger had passed, they lingered. If responding to the shadows were just a reflex, then the flies should come back to the food in about the same time once the threat was gone, regardless of how much they were threatened. It suggested to the researchers that they were calming down from an emotional state, much like how it takes you time to come down after almost getting in a car accident, even though the danger has passed. All of this fly torture may sound like scientists just being bullies, but there's a good reason for it. As first author of the study, William Gibson, points out, flies have the same fundamental drives we do, the four Fs, which are feeding, fighting, fleeing, and mating. But the deeper question is, do they have emotions that can drive these motivations, or is it a mechanical response? Satisfied that the flies may be acting out of fear, the researchers have proposed studying the simple neural network of the flies to see what molecules affect emotional states. Maybe what we find in the flies' brains can be compared to what happens in other animals or us. We know other animals have similar survival circuitry to ours in their brains, but we couldn't know if they felt the same way we do. Maybe it can help us learn about and combat irrational fears too, like fear of spiders. Actually, maybe not. Arachnophobia would be a totally rational fear for a fly. Most of us avoid fear, but some of us can't get enough of it. Trace explains adrenaline junkies here.
Psychologists believe we perform risky behaviors because of our fear response, and medical researchers believe it has to do with the brain's reward systems.
Extreme! So, I think this all raises an interesting philosophical question, which is, at what point does a survival instinct become an emotion? Do you think there's a difference? Let me know in the comments or on Facebook or Twitter at DNews, and I'll see you next time.